Here at Azura, we have over 30 years of experience with complex and unconventional industrial wastewater and anaerobic digestion challenges worldwide. While many digesters are fed with established feedstocks like sewage sludge and manure, we find it more fun to explore the wider range of organic waste that could be diverted to them. So as our clients explore new opportunities, a question we often get asked is, can I put this in a digester? Which is the same as asking, how does this feedstock affect my biogas project profitability and/or operational risk? And the answer is, it depends. I know, classic consulting answer. If you aren't asking this kind of question, let me show you why you may want to. When the feedstock doesn't align with the process, it can result in barriers to digestate disposal, low biogas yield, interruptions to your operations, and at worst, a dead digester. Each of these can be costly for your facility and take precious time to correct. In this video, I'll be telling you what people mean when they say feedstock, common feedstock categories, examples of the different categories, and where feedstocks can complicate your operations. So let's get into it. What exactly do people mean when they say feedstock? Feedstock is what you're putting into your digester in hopes that it will be converted into biogas. It should contain or be mostly made out of organic material, something that can be broken down biologically. More specifically, something that can be broken down by anaerobic microbes. Organic waste comes in many different forms and can be divided into a few categories. We've got source-separated organics, or SSOs, wastewater, agricultural waste, food waste, fats, oils, and greases, or FOG. Those were just a few examples, but the important thing is that all feedstocks are at least a little bit biodegradable, which makes feedstocks a source of food for the bugs in the digester. Bugs need food to make biogas. Organic waste is composed of the same nutrients that our food has. There's calories, the part of food that gives us energy, which are your carbohydrates or carbs, proteins, and fats. Nutrients are like your vitamins and minerals, but for bugs. We have macronutrients, the nutrients that bugs need more of, like nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium, and micronutrients, the nutrients that bugs need less of, like nickel, cobalt, and molybdenum. But tiny concentrations of these are important for making gas. What you feed the bugs directly affects what they produce. That's why your feedstock will affect your biogas and your digest state. Just like humans, you need to feed your bugs a balanced diet that can keep them healthy so that they can work well. When you're wondering if you should accept a certain feedstock, don't just think about the tip fee or the gas you would get out of it. The health of the bugs is important too. Now, realistically, your feedstock will have stuff mixed in it that it's either difficult or impossible to digest by the bugs in the digester. We call these non-biodegradable solids. Some solids are non-biodegradable simply because they don't tend to react with any chemicals at all, let alone bugs, like sand, for example. And we call these inert solids or inerts. Some solids are non-biodegradable because the bugs physically can't eat it, like eggshells and plastic. Non-biodegradable solids can float to the surface or sink to the bottom of the tank as grit. But they can also pass through the digester and end up as contaminants in the digest state. Whether or not the non-biodegradable solids will become a problem depends on what kind and how much you've got of it. So these things are like plastic, batteries, and expired medicines. But not all contamination is bad, just not easily degraded, like eggshells, sticks, and bones. You can also have grit, which could be sand, glass, and metal. You generally want to minimize the grit because it can reduce the effectiveness of your digester and damage equipment. Though some grit is useful for bugs to grow on. The benefits and complications of grit depend on the material, its density, and the amount. Please let me know in the comments if you want me to go deeper on this topic. But let's summarize what we've learned so far. Feedstocks are organic waste that go into a digester to break down. The feedstock affects the gas and digestate composition. And Feedstocks serve as food for the bugs, but they can also contain non-biodegradable materials that the bugs can't eat. Now that you know what feedstock is and what is inside feedstock, let's go over what the different types are and some examples. Here's a graphic that shows some of the common types of feedstocks and how complex each of them is to deal with. Anaerobic digestion plants were originally used as sewage treatment for human waste. With time, technology and our understanding of AD evolved to capture a wider range of organic waste, from simpler feedstocks like agricultural waste to increasingly more complex feedstocks from industrial and municipal wastes. In this section, we'll be starting with the simpler feedstocks and then move our way up in complexity. Something you should know about these categories is that they are not precise. These words may mean different things depending on who you talk to and your location. Let's start with biosolids and manure. Here's part of a wastewater treatment system. When we talk about biosolids as feedstocks, we mean these streams, the primary sludge and the secondary sludge or waste activated sludge. Sometimes they get mixed before going into the digester. Manure is simple. It's poop from livestock. Dairy cattle is more commonly used compared to hogs and beef cattle, and poultry is even less common. We consider these feedstocks simple because they generally have the right bugs in them for making biogas, and they're easier to mix in a digester. The common issue faced with manure digester is the accumulation of grit over a span of several years. Biosolids digesters see the same issues and benefits, but they can also contain human pathogens and therefore have stricter regulations for digestate disposal and handling. Next, we have agricultural waste. Agricultural waste includes manure, but it can also mean crop waste. Think corn husks and wheat straw. Pretty much the part of crops that have the lowest commercial value. You may have heard people call this crop residue or agricultural residue. AD is a way to make use of crop residue's biogas potential before returning their nutrients to the soil. These are a little bit more complex than biosolids and manure because they're harder to degrade. You'll often see them mixed in with something easier to degrade like manure. These crop residues generally have more fiber, which takes more time to break down. If they're not broken down or well mixed enough, they bunch up and form crusts that can clog up pipes, pumps, and other equipment. You can implement a fiber management plan to avoid these problems. That can look like adding a chopper pump before the digester, or maybe recycling some of the fiber in the digestate back into the digester for a second pass. Or in many areas, this fiber can be recovered by the farmer and used as valuable bedding for their livestock. Energy crops and cover crops can also be used as feedstocks in an anaerobic digester. These feedstocks are grown on land or in seasons that is not good for growing food crops and can increase the amount of biogas produced by the digester. Common crops for digesters include corn silage, hay silage, and ryegrass. The practice of buying crops as digester feedstocks is uncommon in North America, but common in Europe where tipping fees are lower and the demand for renewable natural gas is higher. Next, we have industrial and retail food waste. Industrial food waste is a large category that includes a wide variety of very different feedstocks. It's waste that comes from the food processing industry before it gets to the consumer, whether that's from manufacturing or distribution. Examples would be off-spec products or food that don't meet the quality standards, or food processing byproducts like apple cores from an apple pie factory, hooves, bones, feathers, and offal from meat processing, or grease from a bacon factory. With industrial food waste, we typically mean food waste with no packaging. But sometimes, chemicals used in processing like coagulants and cleaners can end up in the feedstock and cause some biochemical problems with your digester. You can also easily upset your digester with some fatty waste if you're not careful. But there are some simple industrial food waste like soda or pop that are easy to digest. And that's because the bugs don't have to chew and dissolve it, which skips the slow biochemical step in anaerobic digestion. Retail food waste refers to waste from grocery stores, restaurants, and other food services. Generally, this would have packaging, cutlery from cafeteria waste, and other contaminants mixed with the organic waste, which makes it a complex feedstock to work with because you have to remove the contamination. Next is source-separated organics, or SSOs. Source-separated organics, or SSOs, are post-consumer waste that involve some effort in separating organic waste from inorganic waste. SSO is a broad and loose category, but some examples are things like green bin waste, depackaged food waste, and yard waste. SSOs can have a lot of plastic, grit, and hard-to-degrade materials mixed into them that needs to be sorted out. SSOs can have a high fuel value, but some of that is lost in the sorting process. However, there are feedstock that has good tip fees, and with the right pre-treatment, existing facilities can be retrofitted to include depackaging and feedstock cleaning equipment so that you can co-digest SSOs with other feedstocks. Other industrial organic waste is a catch-all category that covers any organic waste that could be biodegradable from industries outside of food and beverage manufacturing. This could look like residuals from a biofuel refinery or off-spec medicine from pharmaceutical manufacturing or chemical manufacturing byproducts. On the technical feasibility side, a lot of chemical and pharmaceutical organic waste have ingredients that kill biology. Organic waste outside of the food and beverage industries may also be harder to degrade. With recent interest in producing more biodegradable materials, their waste can be an avenue to explore for AD. Lastly, we have the organic fraction of municipal solid waste, or OFMSW. OFMSW is municipal solid waste, commonly known as trash or garbage that's been collected by the city from your house, the streets, or commercial buildings like offices and malls. These are sent to a material recovery facility to be sorted into recyclables, organics, and landfill fractions. As the name suggests, OFMSW is the organic fraction. As you can imagine, it's not easy to separate the degradable organic waste from all the other waste mixed in with typical trash. The people that sort them and the robots are not perfect. So you'll see some smaller non-organics mixed into OFMSW, like straws, needles, batteries, glass, rocks, sticks, bits of fabric or packaging, and pharmaceuticals and solvents. The amount of inerts mixed into the stream makes OFMSW a very complex feedstock. However, it can have a relatively larger tip fee, and you would be avoiding emissions. Using OFMSW as a feedstock can be a way to divert a lot of waste from landfill. To summarize, feedstocks are organic waste that go into a digester to break down. The feedstock affects the gas and digestate composition. Feedstocks serve as food for bugs, but they can contain non-biodegradable materials that the bugs can't eat. Feedstock complexity depends on the degradability of your waste, its nutritional content, and the amount and type of inerts present. Thanks for watching! Like this video and hit the subscribe button to be notified of our newest videos.